What's good, y'all? It's your boy Little Roy, aka Little Roy TV, and yes, we're back with another video, new video. I do want to say disclaimer, I have unreleased footage that I didn't drop yet, because I've been doing so much that I'm just going to switch it around. This is going to be a day in the life of a sneaker reseller episode 3. I know the last one you saw was supposed to be 1, but ended up being 2. It's all over the place because I've been filming better content that I want to go first ahead of the old content. So before I get into all the details, welcome to the channel. We only have 500 subs. I know I've been trying to do other stuff with this channel. That's why you guys been getting like videos weeks later or a couple days later. I know I've been not slacking, but I'm just trying to build content for you guys in a different way. I'm trying to figure out what I really want to do with this channel. But if you're new here, hit the subscribe button. We only have 500 subs. Like the video, comment. I'll respond to all my comments. Any questions you guys want to get, you know, comment below. And I'll check all my comments as always, and I'll respond back. The day in the life of a sneaker reseller scene, episode 1. I went to this event, and you see the base of the title. I went to the Got Soul sneaker event, sneaker convention. It finally came in New York, and I'm going to see if I'm going to post pictures of who I met there. And you guys will see the pictures of who I met, all the people I wanted to meet. Most of them that was there, main people was people from the Common Hype. So this is the quick little intro. I'm going to do a little talking, and then we'll get into the whole entire vlog, and you'll see what I invested in and all that stuff with all information. Because you see, I got my laptop, so I'm about to show you guys some information based off what I invested in. So let's get right into it. I know it's been a minute since you've seen me sit here. You see sneakers here, but it's got nothing to do with it. You just got no space because I also been working this whole week doing stuff. So it's like I got so much clothes everywhere. Now I finally get a 5-day break, and now I could clean up, figure everything out with the channel, and do everything else, and see what I'm going to post. And at the same time, you know, also explain what I'm going to try to do going forward with the channel as well with the sneaker videos and everything. So let's get right into it. Like my, check out my Instagram and the main channel. Those two links will always be down below in the description. So let's get right into it. I don't want to take up too much time because the video is already long. So let's get right into it. All right. So off rip, I do want to say, I went to the sneaker event and I invested in 2 sneakers. Now, I do want to look it up, not the sneaker I bought, but a sneaker that went up dramatically high, but the market is not going to go like that. Let me see. Syracuse Dunk Low. Everyone knows about the Syracuse Dunk Low, right? They was going for like $300 on market, maybe 2 something, blah, blah, blah. If you look at the market now, every single size from size 7 men's, we'll just do 8 because casually 7, 7.5, that's like Nike size, that's like other shit. Casually from a size 8 to let's say 13, right? That's the normal size people would go for, 8 to 13. They're going for 700, is the lowest, 700. Size 13, 12.5, 11.5. They go to 800,000 plus. Now, I'm not saying these sneakers could hit that because Syracuse, for some reason, is a orange. Crazy that that sneaker went up dramatically high. And also the Kentuckys. So, Kentuckys, Syracuse went up super high. A colorway of orange and a colorway of blue. Surprisingly, Syracuse went up, I guess, because it was limited. And at the same time, a lot of pairs are not on the market, so whoever did get pairs, they sell it, right? But shockingly, orange does good, I guess. Also, look at the college, Syracuse and Kentucky, they're like big college schools, so when they drop the sneaker, it did go crazy. Now, just looking at the market now, you guys know sneakers market is tricky right now. There's a lot of, if you have capital, yes, it benefits. So that's literally what I did. So I invested in 5 pairs each. I forgot because I deleted the picture, but I bought 5 pairs of the purple and 5 pairs of the team red, aka the burgundy one. So I will show you both of them right now. And this is the first time that I did a resale for resale, long term to hold on a more high end product, because you guys know in episode 1 or whatever, or just in general, buying lows and buying the bread toes, they're low right now, they're dramatically low. And as those are just like long short term holds. That makes sense. Like, I'm not holding bread toes to like 2 years. I'm gonna literally, once it goes up, say $50, $80, $100, whatever, 100 plus, I'll give her to all the bread totals, right? But these are more like, if I hold it a year and change, they'll go up, hopefully, if it's not 300, 400, 500, 600, at least it hits. Because I bought these all at different prices, because I got different sizes at the sneaker event, which you're going to see in this vlog. And I'm going to try to speed it up, because I know the vlog itself is already like 12 minutes plus this time. So I want to speed it up. I'm going to show you which one I want to show first. All right, let me show the other one first, because I don't really care about these. But let's, yeah, put the laptop down. This is a size 10.5. The Team Reds. Boom. All right? So Team Reds could be as brown, burgundy, whatever you want to call it. But I do feel like at some point these will go up. I'm still trying to buy certain sizes to hold. But if I don't find it, that's fine. I already spent a crazy amount of money at the sneaker van. Probably put in the title, who knows, just for clickbait. But it's not really clickbait. I really spent, literally, I spent damn near $3,000 at this event. So I might as well put that in the title. So I invested in the Team Reds size, big sizes. But like I said, this event kind of got me upset, overwhelmed, because they didn't really have the sizes I want everywhere. Like, I got 2 10.5s, 11, and other sizes. I think, I don't know if I got 13, 12, nothing of Team Red. But I got 5 Team Reds, like I said, 10, 10.5, 11. So that's these. And then I also invested in the purple ones. Now, this size is a size 7 men's. And even though I didn't want a size 7, I know I have local clientele that wear 7, so I can always sell it at any point. You know what I'm saying? So this is mad cute. I do like this shoe. I tried on the size 9, because I wear a size 8.5 in dunks, but I tried on the 9, and obviously there was a whole gap because I'm an 8.5 in dunks. But I just wanted to try on just to see how it looks, and I do like this shoe. I love purple. As you guys can see, purple is my second favorite color. Red is first, obviously, but you know, I could sell these sizes locally, so that's why I didn't mind buying certain sizes for the price that I paid, which I think for the size 7, I paid $225. Sound like, I think I paid $230. So you think about it, $230 for these. They're not really gonna restock these again. So by the end of the year, you can't tell me this is not gonna be worth more than $230. I could panic sell and sell it for $300. Boom, made $70 though at least. I guarantee $70. Instead of other shoes you buy, it doesn't make $70. Sometimes you do brick flips and you don't even make $30. You might make 10, 15, you know what I'm saying? So at least guarantee this could sell for 70 profit. Even if it was $100, I sell it for 170. I made $70. Either way, still, like I said, these are just more high-end items. That's why they go for a lot. But I wanted to try something different. I already invested in stuff that was below 200. And this time, I went a little higher and I bought stuff that was over 200. I paid, like I said, I paid different prices, different sizes, but I spent the most, I think, was the 220, mostly, on bigger sizes of these and bigger sizes of these. I spent the most was the 230. Yeah. I also invested, and I forgot, literally off my mind, I literally forgot just now, but I also, let's put the purple dunks away. Real quick, let's get into the next clip, because I have to get up and actually get the shoe to show you. I literally forgot I bought these too. Let's get in the clip. Hold up. I'll be back. So, in pretty mids, like pretty mids that you know long-term will go up, I'm just getting them. They're women's, but I get them in quote-unquote GS sizes for girls. So, I'm trying to get 5.5, 6, 6.5, 7, even though they're in women's. So, I got a woman's size 7, which correlates to 5.5, I believe. And this is the Mulberry Jordan 1 mids. Now, certain people, I started seeing investing in these small sizes. So I caught on real quick, and they're not even going for much. So these, I stuck to my gun and paid the price I was willing to pay. So these retail at $140. I bought these off of people for $160. All three pairs that I bought at the event, I bought a size 7, 7.5, 2 7.5, 1 7. So that correlates to a 5.5 and a 6. And I bought them all for $160. So if you could get these Mulberry mids for $160, take it. I literally caught two people lacking. One person was charging $180, and I said, y'all take both, $160. Boom, he made $20. I'm making more than $20. Best believe by the end of the year, this will go up as well. So I caught the Mulberry mids. and as well as those two dunks. Let me, I don't know if I'm going to make a thumbnail, but if not, I'll make a thumbnail now. Put the laptop there real quick. And let's get the thumbnail rolling. Should have done this before. No, I'm trying to speed through because I know the vlog is long. So let's get to all that. Let's do the thumbnail. Thumbnail. Boom. So I'll see you guys next video. Like I said, I'm rushing through this because I'm trying to get you guys into the vlog. So go watch the vlog right now. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you for supporting the channel. Still rocking with your boy. Go run up all the videos if you haven't, if you're new here. Support everything. Thank you. Appreciate you all. That keeps rocking with me. Understands everything that's going on with the channel. I know I've been slow, but I've been trying to just build ideas for the channel. So see you guys in the next one. Like my, check out my Instagram and my main channel. Those links will be down below in the description. And yeah, see you guys in the next one.
Peace the F out.
But I'm back to my old me. That bitch ballin' my homie.
$460, size 7 and 6 in core purple dunks. There you go.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate it. You can shout your stuff.
Follow me, follow me on Sneakers on K's on Instagram.
Couple chains, but you get it now. I'ma split it down, then pass it on. Bitches know the deal when the cast is drawn. It's Cameron J, Mr. Network. Rolling dice with your back work. Made back like Ricky in it. Need some chains, take a bitch to get it. Child dish, I'm a wrist glitter. Big dog, the pick of the litter. Been rich, but that's old news. Just trying to stay up like old dudes. G the light, money, power, respect. When niggas hate, gotta rap.
$20 for the Melbury J. Jordan 1 mids, sizes that I need.
You want to check them real quick?
Yeah. That's 320, right?
Yeah.
They all DS.
Yeah. We don't have any of these. Actually.